I didn't know what I was auditioning for when I auditioned. I auditioned for Geralt's role to start off with, and I didn't get that, which was shocking to me. And then I made my way down to this other unnamed character that was like a mercenary sort of fighter, killer guy, and sent it off, didn't expect anything, and then, yeah, got the job, and we ended up in Budapest. It was really cool. It's been a wild ride. And so once I got the job, I had to do a bit of a deep dive and educate myself pretty quickly, but I had no idea about the Witcher world, and so it was a quick learn. I think the books were definitely like a jumping off point for me. I needed to get my head around the source material because that's always important. I knew from the beginning that the adaptation was always going to be that, like an adaptation of the books. So you always have to, as an actor, you always have to leave room for that adaptation and that whatever the writers want to do with that. But I needed to get across that arc that Cahir has of, you know, his journey from death, grief guy to, you know, lover, savior guy. So I just wanted to get myself across the source material, and then each season I get the scripts and we see where we're going. That's the best, that's why I wanted to play Cahir, because he has that perfect hero journey, a broken hero journey. And as an actor, of course, I get to play every gamut of every personality type. I mean, we start off with obviously a very dark, menacing conjuring of series. And then through season two, as you say, there's a breakdown. He's sort of a broken man. And then as we move through season three and hopefully beyond, we get to see the fully transformation of like what his love and faith can transform him into. So it's wonderful to be able to play all that.